our souls, yes, all those in me, bless his holy name.
Amen. Yes. Thank you for all the praises and blessings of the Lord. Hallelujah. Amen. At this time, we're going to stand. Amen. And welcome our pastor.
Yes.
Amen.
Yes.
As he teaches an awesome Bible class.
Yes.
Kindness unto us and
yes,
the blessings that he has bestowed upon
oh,
us
yes,
throughout the many years.
Oh, yes,
we're coming down to our last Bible class of
amen,
the 2011 year.
Amen.
And God has brought us together and kept us together with his, with our minds stayed on him. It's still Jesus and him only.
Amen.
It's still just Jesus.
Amen.
There is no other God.
No other God.
I'm sorry not to see so many in the service tonight.
Well,
but, you know, the last service and the first service, you look for everybody to be there.
Yes, sir.
But nevertheless.
Nevertheless.
God knows.
Amen.
God knows what is
thank
going
you,
forward.
Jesus.
And therefore, we're going to just continue to praise him.
Hallelujah.
And let him send in more so.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Amen. He's going to send in more so.
Amen.
Let's go to Psalm 51 for our scripture reading. Psalm 51 for our scripture reading.
Thank you, Jesus.
If you got it, say amen.
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 Have mercy upon me, O God, according to thy loving kindness, according to the multitude of thy tender mercies. Blot out all my transgressions. Blot out my transgressions.
Thank you, Jesus.
Wash me thoroughly from my iniquities and
cleanse
me from my
sins. For I acknowledge my transgressions, and my sin is ever before me.
Against thee only have I sinned, and done this evil in thy sight, that thou mightest be justified when thou speakest, and be clear when thou judgest.
Behold, I was shapen in iniquity, and in sin did my mother conceive me.
Behold, thou desirest truth in the hidden part, and in the hidden part thou shalt make me to know his wisdom.
Purge me with hyssop,
yes,
and I shall be clean. Wash me, and I shall be whiter than snow.
Make me hear joy and gladness, that the bones which thou hast broken may rejoice.
Hide thy face from my sin,
hallelujah,
and blot out all mine iniquities.
Create in me a clean heart, O God, and renew a right spirit within me.
Cast me not away from thy presence.
Thank you, Jesus.
And take not thy Holy Spirit from me.
Restore unto me the joy of thy salvation, and uphold me with thy free spirit.
Then will I teach transgressors thy ways,
yes,
and sinners shall be converted unto thee.
Deliver me from blood guiltiness,
O God,
for thy salvation, and my tongue shall sing aloud thy righteousness.
O Lord, open thou my lips, and my mouth shall show forth thy praise. The sacrifices of God are a broken spirit and a broken and a contrite heart. O God, thou wilt not despise.
Do the good in thy good pleasure unto Zion. Build thou walls of Jerusalem.
Altogether, then shalt thou be pleased with the sacrifices of righteousness, with burnt offerings and whole burnt offerings. Then shall they offer bullocks upon thine altar. May the Lord have blessing to the reading of thy word. Before we go in prayer, Sister Ware informed me that her brother-in-law, Frank Perry, is very sick, and we want to pray for him. But certainly he knows about salvation. He knows the plan of salvation. And it's up to them to make their calling and election sure. We saints are going to come to that same point,
yes,
but it's going to be different if we hold on to Jesus.
Yes,
if we hold on to his unchanging hand.
Yes,
it's sad when you come to this point and you don't have Jesus.
Jesus.
It's sad when you come to this point and you don't know Jesus and you walked away from him.
That's
a sad situation. Let us look to the Lord in prayer. Heavenly Father,
Jesus,
in thy precious name,
hallelujah,
we're grateful unto thee.
Hallelujah.
We thank you for your kindness.
Hallelujah.
We thank you for your love.
Hallelujah.
We thank you for this service tonight.
Thank
we thank you
Lord
for those who have gathered into your
thank
house
you,
this night. And thank you for this last Bible class of 2011 that thou hast allowed us to gather ourselves to come together and to praise thy name. Lord, we ask that thou send blessings in the midst of the Bible class. Remember Frank Perry tonight, Lord. Look on him, Lord, and look on his body. You're still able to heal him, Lord. You're still able to deliver him. We believe that you can. Therefore, we ask in the name of Jesus that you stretch forth your hand and that you give the deliverance and let him know that it was the deliverance of Jesus Christ that he is here. Bless tonight, Lord. Bless the Bible class tonight. Bless those that are here. Bless those that are absent. Let your spirit abide with us. Guide us, keep us, and deliver us for thy name's sake. Help us in thy word, Lord. We pray in Jesus' name. Amen. Living, he loved me. Dying, he saved me.
Buried, he carried my sins all away. Rising, he justified, free me forever.
God that is able to bring us from darkness into his marvelous light.
He is able.
I know there's a lot to know about God's word.
Yes.
And long as we live here, there'll always be some more to learn.
That's right.
About God's word.
We Amen. Shall
never come to a point where we know God's word well enough.
All right.
I had one tell me one time he knows the God here inside and out. And I was scared when he said it. Because I don't know the Godhead inside and out. I don't care how much I study it, I don't know it inside and out.
Come on.
Only God knows.
Only God knows.
And only God reveals.
That's right.
But that one has passed on. Thank God that he was saved and sanctified.
Thank you, Jesus.
I just feel there's some things that we need to keep our mouth shut.
Tell the truth.
I believe there's some things that I said that I didn't need to say.
Well, all right.
That I
had
to repent of. So I'm not just saying that because of somebody else.
All right, now.
I believe some things that I said that I have to repent of and get myself straight and that I get it right. But I'm thanking God that he's brought me through the year, at least until this point, of 2011.
My Lord.
If somebody told me I lived to 2011, I just wouldn't have believed it.
Come on.
But I thank God that I'm here. I thank God for all my sisters and brothers. I have two sisters that passed on and one brother that's gone on. Okay. It could be me.
Yeah.
It could be me. But thank God he left me here for another day.
Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus.
Not that I was perfect. Not that I haven't done anything wrong. I don't hold myself up as being somebody that hasn't done anything wrong and won't do anything wrong. But I pray God that when I recognize when I've done wrong, I can repent. I'm getting myself right with God because I want to see Jesus. I've been here 71 years now. I don't want to miss out on Jesus. I don't want to miss out on the promises that he has made us. I guess a lot of folks are saying they'll come out Saturday, so they'll skip the Friday, Wednesday Bible class, because they got to be here on Saturday. But you don't know whether you're going to be here Saturday.
Yeah. All right now.
You don't know whether you're going to make it on Saturday. Hopefully, you will.
Yes, sir.
Amen.
Amen.
Hopefully, those that have thought that way, hopefully that they will be there. But you got to take
every opportunity
to give God glory.
Hallelujah.
And praise.
Hallelujah.
I wanted to be here Sunday, but I know I would be no good on Sunday being here myself. The situation I was in, I knew I had better stay home. It was better for me to be at home and watch it on live video stream than to be in church and have to go in and out. But the Lord bless.
Yes.
It's good. I don't know how many of y'all have looked at the
website.
The website. How many looked at the website?
Amen.
Well, the live stream only happens while it's going on.
No, it's
only while it's going on.
Only while it's going
on. You can watch it later. You can pick it up later, but it won't be live streamed.
YouTube. Okay.
YouTube, or even sometimes she puts it on the website, and you can pick it up. But you can pick it up live stream only when it is live streamed.
Yeah.
So that's where I got it when I was at home. While it was going on, I could see what was happening in church. So it was good to be able to do that. As we grow, and I expect to grow.
Amen.
I said, I expect to grow.
Amen.
We can do more things on our website. I thank God for his kindness unto us. We wanted the place on Joy Road, but they want cash. As I said, they want cash, and we don't have the cash money. If I had the cash, I'd go get it.
Well, thank you, Jesus.
I'd go get it, but maybe one of you all got it stashed away. You want to bring it to me? And we can go do what we need to do. But I thank God for his blessings.
Yes, sir.
And we've been studying in Hebrews, and this is a letter to the Hebrew church, and as I read it, I see so much why they have accredited the book of Hebrews to Paul. Paul was a Pharisee. Mm-hmm. He was one studying to be a Pharisee. There's so many times I wish that I had understood that God wanted me to go into the college to study religion. To study religion. I already knew the faith.
All right. Okay.
But studying religion would help me to understand more about what the Word of God is all about.
All right.
There are so many people that are going to church today. They have no idea of what Scripture is about.
Right.
Scripture is a plan whereby God is saving mankind from their sin.
Yeah.
Man, the saint, he's saving the saints.
Yes, he is.
The saints are saved and he's saving the saints.
Mm-hmm.
But the saints get to a point that they think that they're safe enough that they can make their own decisions. Make their own decisions about what they do. Well, my reading of the scriptures does not give me that sense. It says, know them that labor among you. It says, obey them that have the rule over you, or the guide over you, for they watch for your soul.
Yes,
this is something that you have to come to a point that the leader is not going to act as you think he should act.
All right.
But you should act within the teachings of the leader.
All right.
Amen?
Amen.
You should act within the teachings of the scriptures that the leader teach you.
Amen.
And that's as far as you could go unless God gives you someplace else. You know, so many folks say, God led me. Mm-hmm. Amen?
Amen.
Till you get mad.
All right.
Come on now.
Then God ain't leading you, you lead you. You have to be careful when you start saying, God led me. If God led you somewhere, mm-hmm. He knew what you were going to have to face.
Right.
He knew what you needed.
Yes, sir.
Mm-hmm. Now, if you weren't willing, if you're not willing to take it, remember that you still have to answer to God.
Yes, sir.
All right.
We're saved, mm-hmm. and we're being saved.
Yeah. Yeah.
But there is a place where we can miss out.
Right.
I think, let's see, is that the second chapter of Hebrews? Lest the promise being left us, we should come short of. Well, let's just read the second chapter of Hebrews, beginning at the first verse.
Therefore, we ought to give the more earnest
heed. We ought to give the more earnest heed. We ought to pay close attention. This is when you get mad. And you will get angry. Most likely you'll get angry with me. When you get angry, you ought to really pay attention to what God has said and what the scriptures have said than anything else than what your mind is telling you.
You're right.
Your flesh will get you in trouble. And everybody that listens to you, you will have them in trouble too. Because you spill all of that garbage on them. Come on now. Like you are the only one that's ever been hurt. I've been in church too long to know that I'm not going to get hurt. If I think I'm not going to get hurt in church, I better leave.
Come on.
If I think my feelings ain't going to get hurt, I better leave now.
Right.
Come on now. And I don't go and spew all my stuff on somebody else. I don't want my stuff all over my wife.
All right.
Because it might cause her to fail.
Mm-hmm.
She might take it different than I take it. So I can keep my mouth shut. Sure, there's been things said, things done, that I have to keep my mouth shut and live through it. Therefore, we ought to give the more earnest heed. Read. To the things which we have heard. You know, we hear things, but we don't always take heed. And we don't understand when we do hear them. We don't always understand that down the road is going to take place in our lives when we least expect it. See, when something happens to us, right away we strike back. Come on now. We strike out. That's not God. That's not God. We get mad, we tell everybody else, and we cut them off from the house of God, and because I'm going to cut myself off from the house of God. And they will cut you off. Oh, yes. And then you're out there running. You're out there going from place to place and don't know where to go. Because you said God sent you. But I didn't hear you say God told you to leave. Come on now. You said God sent you. You said he's been sending you a long time. But all of a sudden, you're gone. Pay attention. Therefore, we ought to take the more earnest heed to the things what?
Which we have heard.
Lest at any time.
We should let them slip.
We should let them drift away from us. Mm-hmm. We have to be careful.
Yes.
Don't think you are so established in the Word of God that Satan cannot fool you. Don't get yourself to the place where you think you are so established that you know everything about salvation. You know how the people ought to treat you, but you don't know how to treat nobody else. Come on. Everybody's supposed to treat you right, but you can treat other folk the way you want to treat them. And tell them, you treat me this way. Be careful. Be careful.